speech was intended to be, again, going back to D&D for Gauntlet, was to have the dungeon master sort of be looking over your shoulder off in little snide comments of, you know, maybe you should have done this, or you should have done that, or you stupid idiot, you know, why did you do that? So we came up with really phrases, we created a huge list of phrases we had somebody record there, so you're probably familiar with things like, you know, the elf is taking all the food in.
Elf needs food.
Elf needs food badly.
It's always popular.
That's what elf needs food.
No, I've never said anything badly because it always needs food. Or the one I like is the son of the head has got on the treasure list.
Don't shoot the food.
Me?
Yeah.
Don't shoot the food.
But what was the speech hardware in those machines?
It was just recordings.
It was a TI speech chip that they used in speak and spell.
And was that a 16-bit game or still 8-bit?
It was a done on 68,000. First game was done with 16,000. That's in quality or 16-bit.
It was in order to be one that fits as much back.
Since you
don't remember.
Your velocity is one of the largest cluster register size. You call it 16-bit.
No, you don't.
And you had how much memory to work with?
Oh, God.
Come on. Pull that one out. I did. Well, I could go back to some earlier stuff. I don't remember. You got to understand too. There's program space, and there's, you know, graphic space, and there's alphanumeric. So there's several different address spaces. You know, like alphanumerics just have A through Z and a few special characters. The pictures on the screen were separate from the program. You couldn't access one except through the hardware. Say, look, go draw this, and you knew where the picture was.